Hello everybody and welcome to the part 2 of the TensorFlow Serving example. In the first part, we prepared and labeled a training dataset for the model which should predict the probability of the profit. In the second part, we will create our model using Keras. As you may know, the TensorFlow 2 contains Keras as a high-level API. Then we will export our model to the format required by TensorFlow Serving. And in the end, we will deploy our model using the TensorFlow Serving. Also, I will show how to use different versions of the model. Let's go to the code. In this example, I am going to use TensorFlow 2. Let's import the models and set the default seed for TensorFlow so we can reproduce our experiments. We are going to split our dataset into training and test set. But before we are doing this, we need to normalize our data using the standard scalar function. It is required because our features have different ranges. To create our model, I am using the functional Keras API, but you can use the sequential model if you want. Our model is really simple. We have one input layers with 5 neurons, since we use 5 features, 2 hidden layers and 1 output layer. You can see that the output layer has only 1 neuron. As you know from the previous video, we are using the binary classification model to get the probability of the price touching the take profit level. Here I am using the sigmoid activation function to get the pure probability of our trade. Also, I am using the Adam optimizer and the mean squared error as a loss function. It's not the best loss function for our goals, but it's fine for our example. Let's train and evaluate our model. For evaluation, we will use the test set and test labels. Here, you can see the error and the accuracy of our predictions. Let's store our predictions for the future. Keras provides us with simple methods to save and load our models. Let's check if our loaded model still predicts the same values as before. Okay, we haven't got any assertions, that means the values are the same. Now, let's save our model to the save model format. This format is needed for the TensorFlow Serving. Keras has the experimented methods, export saved model and load from saved model. As you may guess, we are using the first method to export our model and the second one to restore it. We need to specify the path where we want to export our model. Here, 1 means the first version. We need this special structure to let the TensorFlow Serving recognize all your models and all versions of your models. Let's execute this code and check if we are still getting the same predictions. After the restoring our model from the saved model format, we still have the same results. Before we start deploying our model, let's create another version of it, just to add 1 more hidden layer. Train this model, store the predictions and export this model as version 2. Now we are going to start the TensorFlow Serving from the Docker. How to install Docker on Windows you can see on my previous video. Let's prepare our test environment. Before we start the Docker, we need to create the model's config file. This file is self-explanatory. The model version policy parameter is set to all, so we can use all versions of our models. Without this configuration, the TensorFlow Serving always uses the latest version of our models. Now we start the Docker container with the following parameters. Open REST API port and bind our local models folder with the folder in the container. Also, we bind our config file with the same file in the container. Then we start the TensorFlow serving and tell it to use our config file. After the Docker container is started, we can check which models are available. Here we see the two versions of our model are available. Let's check how our models work. We are going to use the features from only one event to check if our models works correctly when we are using the TensorFlow serving. You can see that we got the same predictions using the REST API and the Python notebook. In the end, let's use the REST API from the Python notebook to connect to the TensorFlow serving and check if our prediction is the same as we got early from our model. Oh, we have a problem here. As I mentioned earlier, the TensorFlow serving uses the latest model by default. But we are comparing the prediction from our first model with the prediction from the second. Let's fix our request to use the first version of our model. Now we don't have any errors. The predictions are the same. This is all. I hope this information was interesting and useful. See you in the next video. Bye!